is south of Trimble, but it's so far south that Trimble is closer to Highway 87. So North 101 approaching 87. It looks like the two right lanes are blocked now with an overturned SUV. Injuries, not surprisingly, in this accident, has traffic backing up for a good mile and a half, almost 2 miles, almost back to Brokaw now. So expect growing delays here in San Jose. The reason why the traffic is so slow still on the Santa Cruz Mountains, North 17 up by Laurel, accidents out clear to the side, but apparently they had a flare pattern set out there, and folks are reluctant to drive over it. So we still have very heavy traffic for about 3 miles, North 17 approaching Laurel. We're looking at the closure still, westbound 37, this is coming up on Atherton Avenue up in Novato because of the flooding. We're still being detoured off to Atherton. Not much of a delay now, but you don't even want to get in at that. You may need to take alternate routes around this area. Your next update with George, 1008 on the traffic with your KCBS. Right now in downtown San Francisco, a little bit of sun, but before the day is over, we could also see some showers, maybe even some hail or a thunderstorm. Highs today, low to mid-50s. Traffic and weather together on the 8th on all these 106.9 and AM 740 KCBS.
It's Friday, February 15th, 2019, and coming up on KCBS.
I'm home one at Highway 37 in Novato, where, as expected, floodwaters inundate a key commute route.
I'm making Goldsby in Sausalito, where crews continue to assess the safety of an area where one house slid into another as cranes continue in the area.
And the president declares a national emergency to fund a border wall.
Morning, I'm Stan Bunker.
I'm Kimberly Taylor.
CBS News covers the world next.
When you need to know, KCBS AM, KFRC-FM, and HD1, San Francisco, Oakland, San Jose, a radio.com station.
It's 10 o'clock. CBS News on the hour, sponsored by Rocket Mortgage by Quicken Loans. I'm Steve Kathan. President Trump declares a national emergency to get money for his border wall. CBS's Stephen Portnoy.
He's plowing ahead knowing he'll face legal challenges, but the president says he's declaring an emergency to do what should have been done sooner.
People that should have stepped up did not step up. They didn't step up, but they should have.
Asked if he was referring to former House Speaker Paul Ryan, Mr. Trump refused to say. His administration now plans to redirect some $6 billion from within the Pentagon's budget to build the wall.
When you have that kind of money going into the military, this is a very, very small amount that we're asking for.
Officials have offered no details on what planned projects might be affected.
About those expected lawsuits, CBS's Nancy Curtis.
He may have handed those Democratic lawyers a huge gift right in the middle of his press conference. It was when he said, I didn't have to do this. I could have built the wall much slower, but I'd rather do it much faster.
New steps from the Trump administration on Venezuela. The U.S. has sanctioned the country's oil chief and top intelligence officials. And Pentagon correspondent Jimmy Martin tells us more U.S. aid is being sent to Venezuela's border area in Colombia.
It's a subtle message of trying to up the pressure on Venezuela to indicate that the U.S. is willing to use its military.
Chicago police say they have no evidence to back up reporting suggesting the January attack on Dr. Justice Smollett was a hoax. CBS's Dean Reynolds says two men questioned who worked for the show Empire now considered suspects.
Pointing picture in front is disputing report that Smollett was being written out of the show Empire at the time all of this went down. His publicist says that Smollett went in for a questioning by police detectives yesterday, and he continues to cooperate.
It's bad in parts of California, inundated by rain. CBS's Bola Lange is outside San Francisco.
Firefighters combed through a mountain of rubble to find 76-year-old Susan Gordon trapped up to her neck in mud. Rosalie Bolger saw the rescue.
They were doing it all at the camp with a lot of debris.
Huge tree came down. In Southern California, the same system also brought down large trees and left waterlogged hillsides at risk.
More rains expected.